Hello and welcome to Stop the Press, the brand new quiz show that puts journalists up against the people they're reporting on. On the show, the points really matter. In the next half hour, we'll find out if the professionals can indeed stop the press. I'm your host, Grant Stott, and joining me every week will be our very capable team captains. Heading the journalists' team is the presenter of BBC Radio Scotland's flagship news programme, Good Morning Scotland. It's Gary Robertson.
Thank you, Grant. This week on the press team is a music journalist who writes for The Scotsman, Scotland on Sunday, and The List magazine. And luckily for me, she's a keen rock and pop fan who knows her way around the music history of Scotland very well indeed. So please welcome Fiona Shepherd.
On the opposing team each week, heading the team of professionals, it's one of the most distinctive comedy voices in the country, Joe Caulfield. Hello, Joe.
Thank you, Grant. And I have the lead singer of one of Scotland's most successful bands, Delamitri. He's now a solo artist with four albums under his belt. And if, like me, you remember him from the video of Nothing Ever Happens, he still has fantastic hair. It is Justin Curry.
So let's get started, shall we? Joe and Justin, can you stop the press or will the press stop you? We're about to find out. The first round is called Headlines. I have my wheel of news here in front of me.
Ooh.
Yes, armed with eight categories. We have current affairs, technology, music, film and TV, sport, Scotland, the past loves of Boris Johnson... and the life and works of Ed Sheeran. But which subject will it land upon? I'm going to spin the wheel and ask you guys a series of questions based on the topic that we land on. It's fingers on buzzers to take control of the round. So, where are we going to go first? Let's spin the wheel. Oh, where's it going to land? Oh, there it is. Not Johnson, Boris Johnson yet. It has landed on current affairs. So here's your question, which could help you take control. Fingers on buzzers, guys. This week, Hillary Clinton shared more thoughts on her failed presidential campaign, revealing that she believes she would have won had the election been just 10 days earlier. Before launching her campaign, what was her last official role in office? Gary.
She was Secretary of State.
She was Secretary of State. That's correct. You have now... you have now got control of the game. Okay, over to you, Gary and Fiona. In her interview on Tuesday, Hillary blamed three people for the failure of her campaign. Herself, FBI Director James Comey, and who else?
Ooh. Well, Donald Trump's the obvious answer, but I'm guessing it's not Donald
Trump. He kind of got in the way.
He did get in the way, yeah. Was it Vladimir Putin?
You're saying Vladimir Putin?
I'm saying that.
It's the correct answer. It is Vladimir Putin. So you've got off to a good start. 2 points for that. Next question. During the presidential campaign, what did Time magazine report she kept in her handbag at all times to spice things up on the road?
Is it Bill Clinton's little black book?
Is that your answer, or are you just confirming it loud?
I don't know. What would she have spiced things up on the road with?
What could she have in her handbag?
Hot sauce, something like that.
Sriracha.
Sriracha. The fancy name.
There are obviously other hot sauces available. The one that Hillary chose was Ninja Squirrel Hot Sauce was the right answer. Absolutely true, and she believed it kept her immune system strong. So there you are, wee dietary tips from Hillary as well. Okay then, the third question in this category. Before becoming Secretary of State and the Senator of New York, Hillary Clinton was known worldwide as the First Lady of the United States alongside her husband, Bill. Now, there's potentially 5 points if you can give me three answers in this category here. Excluding Bush's and Trump's, can you name three other First Ladies... since 1900, right? So I need three. Yeah. You'll get 5 points if you give me three. I'm going to give you 10 seconds and your time starts now.
Okay, so Eleanor Roosevelt,
Lady Bird Johnson.
Yeah, and Jackie Kennedy.
Yes.
Already within 5 seconds, congratulations, you got the three. You could have gone for Betty Ford, Pat Nixon, Michelle Obama, Nancy Reagan, the list goes on and on, but 5 points for Gary and Fiona. Joe and Justin, get ready. Fingers on buzzers. We're ready for the next round. Let's see where the spin... we're going to spin the wheel again and see where it lands. Where's it going to stop this time? It's landed on TV and film. Celebrating its 15th year this year, Which Scottish comedy started life... Joe?
Still Game.
Which Scottish comedy started life as a travelling stage show about three pensioners trapped in a high-rise flat? Judah Brogan lived. It is Still Game!
Woo!
You...
You
have control. Jack and Victor, when they're not selling out 21 nights at the biggest arena in Scotland, spend their time in which fictional town and in which fictional pub? I need both for the points.
Do you know?
I don't have a clue. I have watched it. I will admit that.
It's not a crime. It's all right. I do know. I just wondered if you watched it.
Over to you, Joe.
Is the pub the Clansman? Craig Lang is the place, the pub's the Clansman.
I'll give you that's both what we needed. Craig Lang is where they live and the Clansman is where they drink, correct? Still with you, you still have control. Which other Scottish TV show set in another fictional suburb of Glasgow is celebrating its 15th anniversary after debuting on the BBC just 3 weeks after Still Game?
Wow, now, I do know the answer, and I have never watched it, if I'm right.
Right. I don't have a clue.
It's Glasgow, but it's called River City.
It is indeed River City.
River City?
Correct, Joe. Very good. Tuesday night's 8 o'clock. Right. Another TV show celebrating its 15th year is I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here, which started all the way back in 2002. Now, your chance to grab another 5 points. I want you to name three celebrities in 10 seconds who have won the show outright over the years, and your time starts now.
You've got better things to do with your time because
I've watched every single season of I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here.
Carol Thatcher, Tony Blackburn, Kerry Katona... Phil Tufnell.
I'll give you, I was just on the edge. I will give you those three. Phil Tufnell, Kerry Katona and Tony Blackburn. Absolutely right. You could have got Joe Pasquale, Gina DeCampo, Christopher Biggins.
Did Carol Thatcher not win it?
And Carol Thatcher is on my list from 2005. Yes. You're absolutely right.
Because Carol Thatcher, that was the amazing one. Does anyone remember it? Where she peed by her own bed. Do you remember? It was a thing, and they put it on telly, and they showed them reacting because it was such a weird thing to do. And even then, they were commenting, going, but even animals don't do that.
Deeply unnatural.
An animal goes away from its bed.
Deeply unnatural.
Well, for that memory and others, Joe, you got a full 5 points for that one. Congratulations. So at the end of round one, it's Joe and Justin, 11 points, and Gary and Fiona with 11 points. This is Stop the Press on BBC Radio Scotland with myself, Grant Stott. Joe Caulfield and Gary Robertson are with me, and each week we're joined by some very special guests, and this round is all about them. I'm going to ask singer-songwriter Justin Curry questions about music critic Fiona Shepherd. And then I'm going to ask Fiona Shepherd questions about Justin Curry. What could possibly go wrong? So let's start with you, Justin. In an interview with Fiona Shepherd for The Scotsman, you described yourself as what on the eve of your US solo acoustic tour in 2010?
Is it multiple choice?
No, you just...
Was it drunk?
A has-been genius.
It'll be hilarious if it's something really arrogant. Like, I describe myself as a good-looking talented.
No, actually, Justin Curry described himself as the guy at the party who brings out a guitar. And then you went on to say, I don't want to be that guy.
But I'm not that guy. Why did I even say that? I'm the guy that passes the guitar on because I cannot sing when I've had drink inside me. I can't remember anything.
If you were at a party and your guitar was handy and you'd had
I've been known to cut the strings off guitars so I don't have to.
So not an entirely successful answer to that. Okay, Justin, here's the next one. Fiona is the rock and pop critic at The Scotsman and she's lost count of the number of times she's been to Tea in the Park. She was definitely at the first one in 1994 where Delamitri played the main stage. But can you name two of the other four Scottish...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.